Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm going to show you how to build a WordPress site offline. When you're editing a live website, any changes you make will be immediately implemented. That means if you want to try out new coding or experimental software, you could end up breaking your site and alienating new visitors. In this video, we're going to help you solve this problem by helping you create a local, offline version of your website. Before we get started, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, how to build a WordPress site offline. Although there are many different local WordPress development tools that you can use, these can have complicated setup processes. With DevKinsta, you can create your first local environment in a single click. We've built some high-quality features into DevKinsta, like support for PHP 7.2 to 8.0, integration with MyKinsta, local email management, and built-in database manager. DevKinsta can support macOS, Windows, and Linux operating systems. However, before you download our local development tool, it's important to make sure that your computer meets these requirements. Then, the installation process will vary depending on your computer's software. You'll likely need to install Docker Desktop before you download and open the DevKinsta DMG file. Once you install DevKinsta, you can use three different methods for creating a local WordPress website. To make sure you choose the right one for your needs, let's walk through each approach. If DevKinsta was installed properly, you'll see a Create New Site page. Here, you can either add a new WordPress site, import one from Kinsta, or create a custom version. To create a completely new WordPress website from scratch, select New WordPress Site. This will build a local environment that is configured with Nginx, MySQL, and the latest WordPress software. For this method, all you'll need to do is fill out a site name, WordPress admin username, and WordPress admin password. Then click on Create Site. After 30 to 60 seconds, DevKinsta will create a new site. You'll be able to see information about the new database, server, PHP version, and more. During this process, you'll likely have to enter your computer password or accept a confirmation dialog. This will allow the software to make changes to your host's file and finish creating the database. If you have a Kinsta hosting plan, you can clone your existing website. By doing this, you can easily push any changes back to your original staging environment or live site. To get started, select Import from Kinsta. Next, you'll need to connect your MyKinsta account. When you're finished entering your username and password, click on Login. Then pick the site you want to clone to your computer. Since DevKinsta supports both staging and live environments, you can choose either one. If the website is multi-site, specify whether it uses a subdomain or subdirectory. You can select No Multi-Site as well. After you click on Import Site, DevKinsta will create a local copy of the website you choose. When you want to have more control over your local WordPress installation, you can select the Custom Site option. This will enable you to configure specific settings about the site. First, choose a name for the website. You can also name the database and choose a PHP version. Under WordPress Details, you can modify the site title as well as the WordPress version. Lastly, fill out your admin email, username, and password. Once you click on Create Site, DevKinsta will add the domain to your host's file and set up a new database. This should only take between 15 and 20 seconds. After you've created a local website, you'll need to know how to visit and manage it. This way, you can implement changes and evaluate how successful they are. On the site's page, click on the arrow icon to open the front end of your website. To go to your WordPress admin, select a website, then at the top of the site info page, find the WP admin button. In the generated browser, you can fill in your WordPress login information, then you'll be able to view and edit your website using your dashboard. Once you make changes, you can go back to the DevKinsta site info page. By selecting Sync, then Push to Kinsta, you can implement these developments onto your staging or live site. Alternatively, you can also pull changes from Kinsta to this local environment. If you click on Database Manager, you can launch Adminer in a browser tab. Using this tool, you can create new databases, inspect the data in a table, alter column settings, execute SQL queries, and much more. As a beginner, you may only need to create one local WordPress site. However, if you're a developer and you work for an agency, you can build and manage multiple sites in DevKinsta. In DevKinsta, each site runs in a containerized environment. This means that you can add as many projects as you need. To do this, click on Add Site on the home page. By now, you should have a new offline WordPress site and the tools you need to customize it. This can help you develop your website without Wi-Fi and avoid making live coding mistakes. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with an annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.